Good afternoon, students. Today you have written test on Grand Test 8, Zoology, the first question. Arrange the following structures of a typical chordate in correct sequence from dorsal to ventral. From the upper side to lower side. This is dorsal side to ventral side. On the dorsal side, notochord will be there. Notochord followed by nerve cord. Ours is single tubular hollow nerve cord will be present in case of chordates, followed by the elementary canal or gut. Primitive gut transforms into elementary canal, followed by the heart is, in case of chordates, heart is ventral. So from dorsal side to ventral side, if you see the sequence, on the topmost you will get notochord, followed by nerve cord, followed by gut, and then heart. Okay, so what is present, that is, see here, notochord followed by nerve cord followed by gut and then heart. So the option is, first option is correct in case of 136. Next, 137. Identify the steroid hormones that stimulate the RBC production. Erythropoietin secreted by kidney will helps in the production of RBC, and cortisol, which is a glucocorticoid which is produced by adrenal cortex. It is also helpful in the production of RBC, and thyroxine hormone is also involved in the production of RBC, whereas the androgens which are secreted, certain androgen, not the androgens which are secreted by the testes, but certain hormones secreted by the kidney may be involved in the production of RBC. So here the hormones which are purely involved in the production of RBC are erythropoietin, cortisol and thyroxine. So the option 1 is correct in 137. The next one, see here. Which of the following genotype is a dihybrid cross? In a dihybrid cross, how many alleles will be there? 4 alleles will be there. In all the given options, see, only first option is having 4 alleles, so it is a dihybrid cross. If you see the next one, you are having 6 alleles are there. Or in, this is more than 6 alleles, that is 8 alleles are there. So these, it is a trihybrid cross, it is tetrahybrid cross. They are asking dihybrid cross. So among the given options, the dihybrid cross is first option. So 138, first option. See the next question. 139. Radula functions as rasping organ in molluscans. You can find the radula in molluscans. Sea mouse. Scientific name of sea mouse is Aphrodite. Aphrodite. Sea horse. Hippocampus. Aphrodite belongs to Annelida. Annelida. Whereas hippocampus belongs to fishes. Okay. Sea cow. Dugong. Okay. Which are mammals. Whereas sea hare, Aplysia, sea hare, it is a molluscan. So 139, fourth option is correct. Aplysia, see here, Aplysia belongs to mollusca. So out of this, which is the molluscan here? Aplysia, sea hare is a molluscan which contains radula, which is a rasping organ. Next. Choose the incorrect match related to human kidney. What is the incorrect match related to human kidney? Function, okay. Conditional reabsorption of sodium and water takes place in distal convoluted tubule. Yes. In the distal convoluted tubule, based on the metabolism, reabsorption of sodium ions and water molecules will take place in the DCT, distal convoluted tubule. Reabsorption of urea into the medullary interstitium will take place at the ascending limb of Henle's loop. See here, if you see, it is PCT, descending limb of Henle's loop, inner Henle's loop, ascending limb of Henle's loop, and this is distal convoluted tubule, and it is the collecting duct. Major reabsorption of glucose and amino acids will take place in the PCT, proximal convoluted tubule, correct. Selective secretion of K plus ions, H plus ions will take place in the collecting duct. That will not happen. See here. Here, reabsorption of sodium ions and water molecules will take place based on the metabolic conditions. So, it is also correct. From the collecting duct, a small amount of urea is reabsorbed into the medullary interstitial fluid, which is exchanged with the thin segment of ascending limb. Okay, so all the statements are correct, but here secretion of H plus and K plus ions in the collecting duct, it will not take place. Where it will take place? Either in the PCT or in the DCT. In PCT and DCT it will take, but not in collecting duct. So which option is wrong here? Third option is wrong. Incorrect statement is third statement. So 140, third option. 141. Identify the protozoan that causes a sexually transmitted disease. What they are asking, among the following, which is the protozoan? You need to remember this. Protozoan that is causing the STD, sexually transmitted diseases. Chlamydia causes chlamydiasis. It is also a STD, sexually transmitted disease, but chlamydia is a bacteria, but not a protozoan. Trichophyton rubrum, it is causing ringworm, but not the sexually transmitted disease. Trichophyton is a not protozoan, it is a fungi. Okay. Next, Trichomonas. Trichomonas is a protozoan which causes trichomoniasis. Okay, it is a sexually transmitted disease. Trypanoma. Yes, Trypanoma palladium. Trypanoma palladium causes syphilis, which is also a STD, but Trypanoma palladium, it is a bacteria. It is a bacterium which causes syphilis, which is a STD, sexually transmitted disease. But out of the following options, which one is a protozoan that is causing sexually transmitted disease? Means Trichomonas. Okay. The next one. The figure shown below depicts which stage of the cell division? Metaphase, prophase, transition to metaphase, anaphase. So the diagram says that as they are in different regions of the cell, as they are undergoing rearrangement, it is transition to metaphase. Okay. Body is covered by dry and cornified skin with epidermal scales. Means in which class we can see? It is seen in the class Reptilia. See? Hemidactylus. It is a reptile, wall lizard. Hippocampus. Seahorse fish. Bony fish. Okay. Calotis. And chameleon, garden lizard, and tree lizards. These are reptiles. So the option is 143, second option. These two are reptiles. Or see here, why not these two? Carvus is a bird. Clarius batrachus, it is a fish. Cetacula is parrot, is a bird. And Pterophyllum, it is an angel fish. Cetacula, bird. Okay. So, as these are not reptiles, so here the correct option is second option. Now, see here. In a linear chromosome, map distance between four different loci is as follows. What they have given? A to B. If you see A to B, the distance is 10%. Okay. 10%. Map units is the distance. And A to D is 3%. If you are taking A to D, either you can take D this side or you can take D to this side. Once again, see here, the given A to B distance is 10%. Okay. Now the next one, A to D, that means this is a linear chromosome. You can take the presence of D either to the right side of D, right side of A, or to the left side of A. So if you are taking D to the left side of A, see, you have marked like this. Or if you are writing to the right side of A, D will be somewhere else here. The other pen I am writing D. So A to D again, 3%. There are two different possibilities are there for the linear arrangement of the genes. Okay, either to the right side or left side. And then the next one, B to C. That means from B to C. Either you can take this way or this way, but I am taking this way. See here, B to C is 4. B to C is 4%. And A to C is 6. Then only it will be correct. A to C should be 6% only. If you are taking C to the right side of the B, then it will be 16%, which is not mentioned here. So here A to C is 6%. Then the question they are asking is, what is the crossover frequency between A to D? What is the crossover frequency between C to D? C to D, what is the crossover percentage? They are asking. Okay. What is the crossover? How we can say? The distance between the genes is directly proportional to the percentage of recombination. How we will find out the recombinant percentage means, or crossover percentage means? See here, the statement, the distance between the genes, the distance between the genes is directly proportional to percentage of recombination, that is crossover. The distance between the genes is directly proportional to the percentage of recombination or crossing over probability. Okay, so if you take A to D is 3%, A to C is 6%, then what is the distance between D to C? It is 3% if you consider D is to the right side of the A. Or otherwise, if you consider A is towards the left side of, D is towards the left side of A, then what is the crossover percentage? Here, 3% between A to D. Okay. And here, 6% between A to C. So what is the total distance between A to C, C to D? Then it will be 9%. 6 plus 3, it will be 9%. Okay, so either it is 3% or 9%. So the option is 2. 144, second option. Is that clear? 144, second option. There are two possibilities for the taking the linear arrangement of genes. Next one, 145. Genes for which of the following characters in Drosophila were found to be very tightly linked by Morgan? Very tightly linked. Eye color and wing size. If you take the second cross, which was made by Morgan, the second cross, the percentage of recombination is 68.2. See, that the parental combinations are 68.2 and 32.8% are recombinations in case of the first cross. In case of this cross, parental combinations are 68.2% and recombinations are 32.8%. Body color and wing size, he has not made this cross, and wing size and body color, the same one as the first option, in reverse they have given. Body color and eye color. If you take this cross, the parental combinations are 98.2% and the recombinant percentage is 1.7%. Okay, so 98.2 and 1.7% are recombinant. That means if the distance between the genes is very less, it will result in more parental combination. 98.2% are parental combination means the distance between the genes is very less, that they are linked. The strength of linkage is more. So here, that means they are very tightly located. Body color, the gene which is governing the inheritance of body color and eye color are very tightly linked, as we are observing more number of parental combinations rather than the recombinant. But here there are more recombination when compared to the first cross and second cross. So the option 4 is correct with respect to the very tightly linked genes. So 145, fourth option. Next one, in the umbilical cord of human embryo, blood vessels are absent. No, they are present. They contain fetal blood. Yes, it contains fetal blood. Contain maternal blood. No, maternal blood will not be present in the umbilical cord. Why? Because placenta is the barrier for the maternal blood to come into the fetal blood. It will come up to only the placenta. It will not be transferred into the umbilical cord, where the exchange will take place there itself in the placenta. So maternal blood will not be present in the umbilical cord. What is umbilical cord? It is a cord-like structure which connects the placenta to the fetus. Okay, both 2 and 3 wrong. Next, 147. Which of the following syndromes is an example for allosomy? See, allosomal trisomy, they are asking. See, in case of human beings, there are 22 autosomes are there. 22 autosomes and one pair of allosomes. Okay. Down's syndrome, it is a trisomy in case of 21st chromosome, which is an autosome. So it is not a allosomal trisomy. Turner's syndrome, which is containing 45 chromosomes, it is because of monosomy of 23rd chromosome, 23rd pair of chromosome, where only 45 XO condition can be seen. Okay. Edwards syndrome, it is the trisomy in case of 18th chromosome, which is an autosome. But Klinefelter syndrome, see, it is a trisomy in case of, see, 44 plus XXY. Okay, trisomy in the 23rd pair. So it is a allosomal trisomy. Next one, theory proposed by Lamarck. What is the theory proposed by Lamarck? See, continuity of germplasm, that is in case, was proposed by August Weismann, germplasm theory, pangenesis, not panspermia, this is pangenes. So pangenes was talked by this Darwin. And survival of the fittest is also explained by Darwin, but survival of the fittest, the term was the sentence or the phrase was given by Herbert Spencer. And then inheritance of acquired characters, yes, inheritance of acquired characters, use and disuse theory was proposed by Lamarck. The next question. What was the cause for the extinction of Steller's sea cow? So what is the Steller's sea cow? It is a dugong. Okay. Habitat fragmentation, co-extinction, invasion, alien species invasion, and over-exploitation. Direct question it is, because of over-exploitation. Okay. By co-extinction, some plant and its pollinator. If plant and pollinators are mutually related, then if the pollinator exists, the plant will also become extinct. Habitat fragmentation, it is many forest land areas. Invasion of alien species, see, example for this is invasion of, see, alien species like Nile perch. It leads to the extinction of many cichlid species. Apart from that, water hyacinth. Water hyacinth. What is that? Icornia species. Icornia. Okay. These Icornia species. These can invaded the native plants and native plants got extincted. But the reason for the extinction of Stellar sea cow is over exploitation. Here, alien species, either nail perch or Icornia or Lantana. Okay, Congress grass. All these are non-native species which invaded our native species. Next, 150 question. Sustained high fever, headache, stomach pain and constipation are the symptoms of what? See, high fever will be there, 39 to 40 degrees Celsius, headache, stomach pain, constipation are the symptoms of typhoid. Malaria, what is the clinical symptom means? Occurrence of chills. Chills and high fever will be there. Okay. Ascariasis, internal bleeding, hemorrhage will be there. Okay. Amoebiasis, it is a dysentery. Amoebic dysentery, mucus discharge in the fetus. Mucus in the fecal matter can be seen in case of amoebiasis. So 150 question, second option is correct. And the next one, 151. Identify the given diagram and its effect. See, if you see the structure, what is this structure? It is the structure of morphine. And morphine, it is a effective painkiller. Okay, morphine is a effective painkiller. Cocaine stimulant, LSD. Lysergic acid, lysergic dimethyl acid, which is hallucin, and cannabinoids, they are depressant. No, cannabinoids are not depressant, they are stimulants. Okay, anyhow, the given structure is morphine, it is a painkiller. Next question. Which bone articulates with the sternum and acromion process? Where you will come across with acromion process? Acromion process is present in pectoral girdle. In the pectoral girdle, in the scapula region. See, scapula, it is a flat bone, large flat bone present on the dorsal side of your shoulder region. On the dorsal region, okay, whereas ribs do not have any acromion process, okay, but they are attached to sternum. Clavicle is the collar bone. It is the collar bone which will attach to both the sternum and it possesses a acromion process. Coracoids, these are not attached to sternum. Okay, so the option 2 is correct with respect to 152 question. Now question number 153. Question number 153. See, air pollution and control of pollution, Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act in the year 1981. Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act in the year 1974. Environmental Protection Act in the year 1986. Earth Summit in the year 1992. What is this 2002? World Summit. So what is the correct option here? In the given option, second option is correct. 153, second option. Human urine is usually acidic. The acidity is because of secretion of H+ ions. Okay. H+ ions are actively secreted into the filtrate. Yes, through the collecting duct. Apart from that, from the collecting duct. The sodium transporter exchanges one hydrogen ion for the sodium ion in the peritubular capillaries. No such type of mechanism you can see. Excreted plasma proteins are acidic. Plasma proteins are not excreted, they are reabsorbed. Potassium and sodium exchange generates acidity, does not generate any acidity. So acidity of the human urine is because of H plus ions that are actively secreted into the filtrate. Correct. In humans, part of the fallopian duct that is closest to the uterus. What is the part of the fallopian duct? If you see, it is a funnel-like structure. These are fimbriae followed by in the female reproductive system, the finger-like projections of the fallopian tube are known as fimbriae, and the funnel-like structure is infundibulum, followed by the narrow part of this, it is isthmus, followed by this is the uterine region or uterine cavity. Here, which is the closest part to uterus, they are asking. The closest part to uterus is isthmus. So, option 4 is correct. The closest part to uterus is isthmus. Next, 156. The extinct human who lived for about 1 lakh to 40 years ago in the Europe and Asia. They are asking in the Europe and Asia. In Europe and Asia, they are Neanderthal men. Whereas, this Homo erectus in Java. And Australopithecus in East Africa. Okay. So here the person who lived in Europe and Asia are Neanderthal man. Okay. The brain capacity of this Homo erectus is 900 cc. Whereas Neanderthal man it is 1400 cc. Homo sapiens is 1600 cc. Okay. Is that clear? These Australopithecus about 2 million years ago, they were found in the East Africa. So here the option 2 is correct, 156, second option. An area in the brain which is associated with strong emotions. Strong emotions means the limbic system along with hypothalamus. Limbic system along with hypothalamus controls these emotions, whereas cerebral cortex, it is associated with memory, consciousness, language, alertness, everything. The majority of the neural control are under the control of the cerebral cortex, which is the largest part of the brain. Cerebellum, which is controlling all voluntary movements. Voluntary movement. That's why if a person is drunken, the cerebellum will be affected, so he cannot maintain his postures or when the his gait, walking gait cannot be maintained if the cerebellum is affected. And medulla, it is controlling, it is a respiratory rhythm center, and it is also controlling the vomiting sensation. Respiratory rhythm center or vomiting, or it is also controlling the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. Sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, next one followed by this. 158. Which of the following is not a reason that accounts for greater diversity of tropics? See, tropic, when you compare the tropical region to the temperate region. Temperate regions are North Pole and South Pole. Okay. And this is the region which is nearer to the equator is the tropical region. So it is Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn. 23 degrees north and 23 degrees south latitudes. If you compare the species richness in these regions, there is more greater biodiversity in the tropical region when you compare to this temperate regions. Why? Because, see, availability of more sunlight is there in the tropical region. There is more niche specialization is there and more time for the species for species diversification. Yes, correct. But if you compare to this temperate region, they are frequently affected with certain natural calamities. What are they? Frequent glaciations. glaciations are there in case of these are temperate regions, so there is no enough time for the species to get diversified, and they are less seasonal. Okay, they are more seasonal in case of temperate region, but tropical regions are less seasonal. So which is not a reason means large seasonal variation. We cannot see large seasonal variations in the temperate region. More seasonal variations are there. Okay, during breathing, diaphragm is arched. When it will be arched? During relaxation. That means after exhalation or expiration. See, expiration is a passive process. So contraction of phrenic muscles, it is during inspiration. Contraction of it is during normal inspiration. Along with this, external intercostal muscles, it is during forcible inspiration. Okay, relaxation of diaphragm, yes, correct. Upward movement of ribs and sternum, this is also during inspiration. Okay, inspiration, this will take place. So diaphragm is arched only when it is in relaxation. Okay, third option is correct. Tendons and ligaments are formed by which connective tissue? They are formed by dense regular connective tissue. Cartilage, irregular, they are wrong. Irregular is present in case of a skin. Areolar connective tissue, which is a connective tissue present beneath the muscles and all. So 161, appearance of dry scaly lesions on the skin with intense itching is the main symptom of which disease? It is the symptom of ringworm. So ringworm is caused by trichophyton, epidermophyton, okay, and microsporum. All these are fungal species. Okay, Babesia, it is Babesiasis, which is a bacterium. Streptococcus pneumonia, it is also a bacterium which causes pneumonia. And Mycoplasma, it is also bacterium. Okay, they will not cause this ringworm. The next one, 162, Urtica. Urtica can be seen in case of females. These are the in which eggs are laid. Okay, it is a case-like structure in which eggs are present. Is out of this, which is the gland that is present in the females? Collateral gland, whereas conglobulate gland is present in the male cockroach. Cowper's gland, it is not present in the cockroach. It can be seen in case of human males. Okay, utricular gland, it is also seen in case of males. So 162, fourth option. Next one, 163. The neural system is well organized with the brain and number of ganglia and neural tissues in case of Hydra. There are only diffuse nerve net will be there in case of Hydra. And insects, yes, if ganglia present means in insects, correct. Birds and fishes, they are chordates or vertebrates. The brain is well developed in case of them. There are ganglia will be absent. Okay. The next one. 164, in human male reproductive system, ejaculatory duct is formed by. Ejaculatory duct is formed by the duct arising from the seminal vesicle and vas deferens. So here the option is vas deferens and seminal vesicles, not ureter or prostate gland or urinary bladder gland. All these are wrong. Vas deferens combines with the duct arises from the seminal vesicles and forms a duct called ejaculatory duct. 164, fourth option. 165. Ancestors of Tyrannosaurus is, even though Tyrannosaurus, their ancestors, it is not mentioned in NCERT in a printed form. If you observe the diagrammatic representation of dinosaurs in the evolution chapter, you will come to know, you can analyze who are the ancestor forms and who are the evolved forms. Okay, so on the basis of the diagrammatic question, it is a diagrammatic question from the chapter evolution. See here, Tyrannosaurus is the ancestor of Tyrannosaurus is Brachiosaurus. Okay, whereas Styrosaurus, it is the ancestor of Triceratops. Triceratops is the it is a evolved form which is evolved from Stegosaurus. Okay, Archaeopteryx and Pteranodon, they are evolved from the crocodile-like ancestor. Okay, followed by such type of questions can be asked. Okay, don't neglect the diagrammatic parts which is present in evolution chapter. Functionally, cardiac muscles are similar to. See, anatomically, cardiac muscles are striated muscles or striped muscles. This is anatomically or morphologically. Or morphologically. Okay, unstriped muscles. But functionally unstriped muscles because they are involuntary in function. Pacemaker is present. Okay, involuntary in function. So the next question, read the following statements related to the skeletal muscle and choose the correct option. The binding of calcium ion with a subunit of troponin removes the mask of actin binding sites on myosin. No, actin binding sites on actin filament. Okay, sorry. Okay, here this is wrong. Actin binding sites on myosin. Myosin binding sites on actin filament. Okay, so this statement is wrong. After muscle contraction, calcium ions are pumped back into the sarcoplasm cisternae, which results in masking of actocytes of actin filaments. That is true. So first option is wrong, second option is correct, so fourth option is correct. Next one. If a meiocyte contains 20 chromosomes, what will be the chromosome number at each pole during anaphase 1? See, anaphase 1 in the meiosis is very significant phase because it is characterized by disjunction of chromosomes. Disjunction of chromosomes will take place in anaphase 1. Okay, disjunction of chromosomes will take place during anaphase 1. That's why meiosis 1, it is known as reductional division. Reductional division. Why it is called reductional division means the number of chromosomes will be reduced to half in case of this meiosis 1. In which phase of meiosis 1 it will take place? In the anaphase of meiosis 1. So as a disjunction of chromosomes takes place, the chromosomes will move to the opposite pole. So at each pole, half the number will be present, that is 10 chromosomes. Hope I am clear this. The next one, inulin consists of, inulin is a homopolymer of fructose. Okay, inulin is a homopolymer of fructose. Only glucose, only maltose or protein. Okay, not present. Whereas cellulose is present in case of this fructose is the inulin is the homopolymer of fructose. Second option is correct. The next one, where does exchange of takes place between blood and tissues? It is not with the arteries or the veins. It is at the capillaries. Fine branching like structures present at the end of the blood vessels. Where exchange of substances will take place. The lens and eye are held in place by the ligaments attached to cornea, no, iris, no, sclera, no. It is to the ciliary body of choroid. Okay, so which option correct? Fourth option is correct. Sclera, choroid and retina are the three parts of the outer layer of the eye. Now, the type of immunity that is administered by you by administering tetanus toxoid is, what? See, natural active immunity. Natural active immunity means that we can be seen in case of smallpox. Yes. Natural passive immunity. Natural passive immunity 3 means by IgA and IgG antibodies, which is provided by through the mother's placenta and through colostrum, first secretion of milk of mother. Okay. Now, artificial active immunity. Artificial active immunity, that is vaccination. Artificial passive immunity that we will get when we take the performed antibodies are ready-made antibodies. If you take such in tetanus case, the performed antibodies is given, which comes under artificial passive immunity. Okay. Now, the catalytic efficiency of two different enzymes can be compared by formation of the product. Now, catalytic capacity. Optimum pH value, no, Km value, Michaelis-Menten constant, yes, Km value, or molecular size of the enzyme, wrong. So which option? Third option is correct. The sequence of the following, the sequence of opening and closing of the heart valves. See, first atrial depolarization followed by ventricular depolarization will take place. Yes, and then it is a joint diastole or atrial systole followed by ventricular systole followed by joint diastole in case of the cardiac cycle. So during atrial systole, atrioventricular valves open first, means before this atrioventricular valves open, before the closure of a semilunar valves it does not happen. Atrioventricular valves close and before the closure of semilunar valves, no, atrioventricular valves open after the closure of semilunar valves. Okay, atrioventricular valves close with the closure of, it does not happen. So you do remember, during atrial systole means because of contraction of atria, the atrioventricular valves open. When the atrioventricular valves open and pumps the blood to ventricles, then the semilunar valves open because of ventricular depolarization or ventricular systole. When the these semilunar valves get closed, then the atrioventricular valves open in the next heartbeat in the cardiac cycle. So you should remember this: atrial systole followed by ventricular systole followed by joint diastole. So the correct option is third option. The next one, among the following, the number of freshwater fishes are Katla, Rohu, Common Carp, Hilsa. Hilsa, it is marine fish. Sardines, Markel also, marine pomfret. So how many are there? Three are there. A typical fat molecule consists of one glycerol and three fatty acid molecules. Yes, remaining options are wrong. Resinous membrane separates scala vestibuli and scala media. Yes, very correct. Whereas tympanum and pharynx, eustachian tubes are present in between them. Fenestra rotundus and fenestra ovalis, these are the two windows present, okay, openings in the ear. And next, scala media and scala tympani, the membrane separating scala media and scala tympani is Basilar's membrane. Okay. And the next one, among the following, which hormones are co-workers? Insulin and glucagon are antagonistic in function, which increases insulin decreases blood sugar level, whereas glucagon increases blood sugar level. Blood sugar or glucose levels. Gastrin, enterogastrin. These are also, gastrin will stimulate the secretion of gastric juices, whereas enterogastrin will inhibit this gastrin. Epinephrine, norepinephrine, both are together called as stress hormones or fight hormones. Catecholamines, which are secreted by adrenal medulla. Okay. Somatotropin and somatostatin. Somatotropin, which is a growth hormone, somatostatin, which is inhibiting the growth. So the hormones which are co-workers, the epinephrine and norepinephrine, both will increase heart rate. Okay, epinephrine and norepinephrine increases the heart rate. So the co-workers means same function. Co-workers are the enzymes which are having the same function, are known as co-workers. So 178, third option. Now 179, the number of possible gametes in the genotype, capital A, small a, capital B, spawn B, capital C, small c, capital D, capital A. That means out of the given genotype, how many are heterozygous? This is heterozygous one, this is also heterozygous, this is also heterozygous, this is homozygous. So what is the formula here? 2 power n. What is this n? N is equal to number of heterozygous genes. number of heterozygous genes. That means heterozygous genes, how many are there? Three are there. 2, so 2 power 3. That is 2 into 2 into 2. 2 to 4, 4 to 8. 8 is the answer. Okay, number of gametes. How many different possible gametes? 8 possible gametes will be coming. Which of the following is the correct combination for aquatic mammals? All aquatic mammals means whales, dolphins and seals. Whereas here shark is a fish, trigon is also fish. So these are not mammals. Thank you.